the causality of this event that is predicted is basically because we are in this transformation. It's not just the planet, it's the solar system. We're experiencing it here, but it's the end of an age. It's the end of an era. It's the end of an epoch. And we are at the threshold, the bridging point between this old paradigm and this new paradigm. And how this plays out in the next decade is largely up to us. And I would say to you that waiting for an event is extremely another form of disempowerment, because we're not actively taking responsibility for our own evolution. We're not actively engaging the process of growth, of inner transformation, and simply waiting for the universe to do the work for us. Now, that is actually happening to a degree at the same time, but it doesn't dissolve us of our responsibility, absolve us of our responsibility that we need to make our own efforts in order to integrate this energy coming in, because it's going to get more and more powerful. And even in the last couple of months, the energy has becoming flowing stronger into the subtle bodies. And this means the activations are getting more profound and they're getting stronger. But it's not happening in a linear time frame. So don't think an activation next week will therefore be stronger than an activation that was a month ago, because it's not working that way, at least as I perceive it. Now, one of the most important things that I would like to share with you is we need to be open to receive the subtle energies that are now bathing the planet. And by that, imagine if we're wearing a spacesuit. If our energetic body is blocked and we're not open, then we can't receive. So we're not creating the conditions, the fertility of our energetic body to receive that basic subtle energy, which is now of a very high vibration and it's coming spontaneously. So the thing to understand is that things like diet matter, because that helps purify our nadis, our energetic body. And not only diet, but lifestyle, but getting out in the sun, but exercising, but the mind-body connection, yoga, tai chi, qigong, meditation, and our overall integration into our daily life. Evolution is happening always here and now. It's not always happening somewhere else or a time in the future. And that means an empowered state is to take responsibility for that and to be open to receive. The earth is shifting her vibration as well. And for this reason, I started myself to try to integrate more strongly with the earth itself. And it doesn't come naturally to me, but I'm trying to, when I walk on the beach, I'm trying to feel the energy of the earth. I'm trying to look for synchronicities in the sky, trying to perceive the earth herself, the shift she's going through, because our consciousness is related to the earth's consciousness and she is transforming as well. So the more we can become grounded in this way and connected with the earth, we can understand her journey. And this is having an effect with the Schumann resonance, which of course, as you know, it's been spiking a lot. And even a few weeks ago, there was a very powerful spike, which I think that this will be another hot topic going into the next decade, what's happening with this, and there will be a new norm. And when we ask, when will the shift happen, a better question is, how long will it take someone to forgive? How long will it take someone to become compassionate? How long will it take 7 billion people to have a higher frequency? That's a better question. Because when we think of that, then we're talking in terms of critical mass. And so then it's our responsibility to co-create the shift and not be passively, again, in a state of disempowerment, waiting for the shift to occur. And in conclusion, I'd like to paraphrase by saying, ask not what the shift can do for you, but what you can do for the shift. Thank you.